For the debate, first, the timing of speech are as follows. When there are 30 seconds left, you will hear a sound. When time is on, you will hear a moment. After that, for every 10 seconds, you will hear a moment. When it's 30 seconds into your extension, you will hear another moment. And upon hearing that, you have to stop your speech. And the rules for attending your class examination are, when they are 30 seconds left, you will hear a showing. When time is up, you will hear a showing. And upon hearing that, you have to stop your class examination.
Each team needs to prepare this class for class examination. Any advanced lighting journal event should have a corresponding advanced card, which may be revealed on her request by the course examiner and estimate. The cards need to be returned at the end of the conference stage following the course examination.
For the audience, please turn off your cell phone or mute your vibrator. When the debate is still in progress, please do not turn off your display and take a mute.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We, the affirmative, strongly believe that Taiwanese government should reduce the time that secondary school students spend in school each day. First, let us define the topic. The secondary school we're talking about are both municipal junior and senior high school, and does not include private schools, which the government can manage. And the amount of time students spend at school is the time that they are required to stay at school by the law. As for the state of school, which is under the 99 curriculum guideline, students stay at school from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. Our plan mainly focuses on two major problems from the state of school we'd like to change. First, inadequate sleep. In Harvard's medical research article, the price of inadequate sleep is increased risk of multiple life-threatening illnesses, such as obesity, diabetes, heart disease, and collapsed immune system. Teenagers are supposed to sleep for at least 8 to 10 hours. Meanwhile, due to the early school starting time, 2 out of 3 high school students in Taiwan can't get more than 8 hours of sleep each day. According to National Sleep Foundation, because of the unique biological clock teenagers have, they will not feel tired until after 11 p.m. If they sleep for a healthy 9 hours, they will wake up at around 8 a.m. According to Brain Thinking Organization, adolescent brains do not start releasing melatonin, which is a hormone promoting sleepiness, until around 11 at night and keep pumping out the hormone past sunrise. With all that melatonin surging through their bloodstream, teenagers who are forced to be awake before 8 in the morning are often barely alert and wind up in sleep. According to an experiment conducted by National Sleep Foundation, delaying school starting time has in fact been proven to lengthen the amount of time students sleep. Therefore, in our plan, we delay the school starting time to allow students to have a longer sleeping duration. Also, there is a direct relationship between concentration and sleeping time. If students don't have enough time to sleep the night before, they would have trouble concentrating in class the next day, which strongly affects their quality of study. A study held in Israel used 2 separate groups of 13-year-old students and delayed 1 group's school starting time by 1 hour for a week. Results showed that delayed group performed much better in a concentration test than the other. Since we honor the school starting time, students will sleep for a proper amount of time, and they can better concentrate in class than before. The second harm, not enough time for students to pursue interests. Secondary school students are at the golden age of pursuing their interests, exploring their future career, and increasing their non-academic ability. Let's say they have to go to bed at 11. In our plan, which makes the school end at 3, we give them 8 hours to utilize. According to Child Rights Organization, 69.3% of junior high school students in Taiwan don't have enough time to do things other than academics. This means that the time students have after school is obviously too short for them. Our team has come up with a plan which can fix the above problems. We delayed our school starting time from 8 a.m. to around 9 p.m. and end at around 3 p.m. This gives students more time to utilize. Because of cutting up about 2 classes per day from the senior school, we made some adjustments to balance the schedule. For instance, we're going to remove all the non-academic courses except from art and PE, making students choose from music, visual arts, and performing arts. Also, we combine all three social studies into one subject, focusing on theme-based teaching. Change science from four classes into three classes. These changes make it possible for students to participate in one period of elective courses and one club-related elective courses activity every week. Elective courses are different types of classes, and students have to choose one type from these courses. All the budget we need for elective courses will come from the budget the government has prepared for the 101 curriculum, which also aims to offer students elective courses. As for how we are going to execute this plan, we will delay the start time of all secondary school starting in year 108. As for the elective courses, they will first be put to work in 7th and 10th grades, and on the second year, the 8th and the 11th. Finally, on the third year, the 9th and the 12th. For rural area or those who have financial difficulty finding a place to develop their interest, we will provide them free optional courses after school to compensate their insufficient resources. In conclusion, we the affirmative strongly suggest the Taiwanese government reduce the amount of time students spend at school for a healthy lifestyle, increasing their concentration, and pursuing their interests. I'm now ready for the cross-examination.
Second year to cross examen, first three minutes.
So your plan is to change the time schedule to from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m.
Yes.
Okay, you said you're cutting off, I hear many details, but you said you're cutting off one science class.
Yes.
Then how is it going to be enough time for teachers to teach it?
Well, the teaching way is going to change, like in the first year of, in the first semester of senior high, they will learn chemistry and on the second semester.
You're making a counterpoint based on the one that can read on.
Well, it's not exactly the same.
But based on
elective courses part, yes.
Okay. Then are you changing the college entrance exam?
Yeah, we're going to change the college entrance exam. The students can choose the subjects that the department wants them to take.
So if you want to go to some, if you want to major in some subjects that really need science, then if you're cutting off science, how are they going to get it out?
Well, they will have elective courses for science, advanced knowledge, if they want to take that.
Okay, you mentioned an evidence from Israel.
Yes.
Can I take a look at that?
Oh, yeah, sure.
What is the sample size of the data?
What?
The sample size of the evidence.
Samples? You mean the Israel?
Like how many people got surveyed?
Well, it is not sure.
There's an evidence that teens are supposed to sleep 8 to 10 hours.
Yes.
Can you take a look at
that? Okay, sure.
You mentioned about melatonin, which affects the teenager's sleep, right?
Yes.
So you're delayed. Does delaying the schedule, the whole schedule, help with that?
Well, of course, but we did delay the time.
So about the concentration part, you said that they don't have enough, because of the long class times away from concentrating.
Well, no, I said that because of lack of sleep.
Okay, so if delaying the whole schedule, they can, then the sleep problem is solved, then the concentration problem will be solved too, right?
But they don't have enough time to perseverance,
do you have evidence about that? That the teenagers don't have enough time?
Yes, she do have.
Okay. And there's an evidence that 69.3% of students do not have, oh, this one.
Yeah, they have one. Okay.
Yeah. And the concentration part, does like cutting each big period into smaller sections with recesses between them help?
Our evidence showed that is delaying the school time and they can have better grade performances and also concentration.
Does that mean beside that, like just thinking straightforward, if you cut a whole section into two and then put recesses between them, then you can like go half the class and then you can stay up, you can relax for a moment and then go on the next one. Does that help? Do you think it helps?
Well, if you have evidence to show that. I'm not sure about that.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
speech, 5 minutes.
Good morning. We as an active team strongly oppose the resolution, and we will prove to you that the status quo had already provided a good enough system, and that it would be a bad idea to implement the plan of the affirmative. I would like to start with the harms claimed by the affirmative. The affirmative's first harm was sleep deprivation. The affirmative told us that students should get 8 to 10 hours of sleep, which is the time recommended by the National Sleep Foundation of the United States. However, the research is actually sponsored by companies that manufacture sleep medicines. Researchers are supposed to be objective and independent, but how can they do it independently if they are paid for by the drug companies? We would doubt the credibility of their evidence. The next question is about concentration. The affirmative told us that Israel research, but the research is actually about the subjects are actually in elementary school, which is not the subjects that we are talking about today. And the sample size is only 34 people. So we definitely do not think the result can represent the general situation of Taiwanese students. We can actually totally agree on the problem that the affirmative mentioned. Melatonin, a hormone of teenagers related to sleep quality and health, justifies the significance of the problem. So to solve the problem, we and active are making a minor repair to postpone the entire school schedule for 1 hour, which means students will get to school by 9 a.m. and leave at 5 p.m. And the affirmative also admits that by delaying school time, we can solve the problem about sleep deprivation. Next, during the cross-examinations, we do not believe that the status quo, which is the 1A curriculum, has already provided a good enough system for students. Compared to a previous 99 curriculum, the 1A curriculum not only reduced compulsory subjects, but also arranged more elective courses in order to develop important civic literacy, such as critical thinking, media literacy, and environmental awareness. By offering more diverse courses, we are handing over the choice of education that students receive to themselves, while ensuring that they are equipped with critical thinking skills when they graduate. In addition, the 1A curriculum also outlined the goal to empower each and every student by shifting the role for students from lecture receivers to autonomous learners. By providing more interdisciplinary learning programs and adjustments about calculation of credits and scores of exams. Second, if we reduce school hours, which is the most important part for teachers when planning courses, the time will be insufficient to educate students. Reducing school time not only lessens things students learn, but also ignores the needs that students have to cultivate those important abilities. With sufficient teaching hours, teachers can provide students with structured guidance. If the affirmative reduce school hours, it will be sure that the time students stay and interact with teachers would also be reduced. However, we at Netflix do not think this is a good thing. According to a research from the University of Auckland, teachers is the most effective factor besides students themselves. Teachers not only provide qualified lessons to students, but also give students feedbacks, personalized consults, and direct instructions. Due to the result, reducing time students spend with teachers will definitely cause negative impacts on students' future career and achievements. Now I want to talk about affirmative plan. If the affirmative really believes that the skills provided through those elective courses are important, why do they make them optional? If they don't agree that the skills are important, why do they even bother to provide it? We at Active have proof that reducing school hour won't do any good to students, yet hurting their rights to education. School hour isn't a reason for the affirmative's harms. The methods of teaching are. Therefore, the negative contends that the harms do not hold meaningful significance or prove they're inherent to today's topic of debate, and the problems could all be solved by implementing the already planned 1A curriculum. Hence, the reason for implementing the affirmative plan would cease to exist. About that students don't have free time. In their survey, over half of the subjects are actually from elementary school. So we also do not think it can represent the represent the subjects of Taiwan, students of Taiwan, yes. And I stand for a prize examination.
First affirmative, cross examine first next year.
Good afternoon. You're saying that you're going to reduce compulsory classes?
Yes, in the 108 curriculum, the government has reduced some of compulsory
subjects.
Oh, like it's like Chinese, math, and English, and those subjects. And I, and